Welcome back to Let's Play Beyond Skyrim Blind. Here's the guy that I wanted to talk to. Oh, wait. I gotta reload. Well, hold on a second. This thing keeps, technical problem. If you can hear that? Dunno, but... I should be good now. Okay. This is the guy we were looking for, and his house is always locked. Hey. I said hey.
Welcome, traveler.
You mean welcome back. I killed the Alpha Wolf and his pack prowling near the village.
Thank you, stranger. You've done this settlement a world of good. Here, take some coin as a small token of my, our thanks.
Well, thank you. Ooh, 750 gold. This guy's got money. Okay.
Until next time.
Until next time.
Are you an adventurer? You're an adventurer, aren't you?
Yep. I do that adventuring stuff. You know?
Wow. I bet you see all sorts of things. And I bet you have a sword. And can fight.
I'll fight you. You better run. Alright, let's go back to... Bruma. We need to catch up with Renod Even-Toned and... Adius Villius, the captain of the guard. The Dawngold. Alright, so...
Please, madam. Just one step, Dim. It is good to see a familiar face around here, friend. Bless you, madam. Bless you. Not today. My back. Farewell.
It's been a while since you've been out.
Relgar?
I know.
Except Dim for Nargonian down on his luck.
I just gave you money.
Have you come to learn?
Can I help you?
Or just to bother an old collector?
The Grizzly Hunt. Oh, I guess I talked to him. The Grizzly Hunt?
Sure I can. I was out for a normal trek into the wild, and I found these tracks you see. They weren't any ordinary tracks either. They were big, huge, larger than any bear print I had ever seen before, or since. I knew it was foolish to chase after such a monster, especially with the snow coming down as hard as it was.
I don't know if you heard that.
But I just thought of how beautiful its head would look, mounted over my mantle, and I pressed on.
Say that.
It found me on the slopes of Dive Rock, galloping from a copse of trees, faster than an avalanche. Its roar louder than thunder. I didn't have time to put an arrow into his heart. I dropped my bow, pulled out my axe, and danced with the beast on that mountain. Hmm. Fortunately, such a creature is not well suited for hunting on the steep crags of the Geralds. After a little tussle, I sent the beast tumbling off the cliff to its death. Took me nearly a week to find, clean, and haul the carcass back to Bruma. Now it sits above the fire, a proper trophy.
See you.
See you after all that. Galarin?
What can I do for you?
I guess I'll talk to these people. There's just so many, I've forgotten them.
Until next time.
Yeah, until next time. So I gotta meet up with... Well, let's get this working here. The Screeching Songman. Report the findings to Adius Villius. I don't really have that. Where is he? He's at the Hammer's house? Alright, I'll head to him.
Leave me alone, would you?
Excuse me? Got some nerve talking to me like that. Alright, it's this way, it's the other way. Oh. That's a dead end.
Calm down.
No, running, running. Is it back behind here?
I could have sworn you... Aha!
No aha!
There's a skeeving thug inside my house! When are you going to do something?
There's a trap door inside your house, you know that. I don't want to march in there in case they're planning an ambush.
There's a trap door inside my house! I didn't realize that until now.
Let's just wait a few minutes, and see if the thief decides to try his luck leaving the building, before we do anything rash.
Damn it all! Skeeving thieves can just wander inside while I'm sleeping and steal what little coin I have left to my name. Kinnereth, give me strength!
Ah, you're back. Come, we need to talk. As you can see, there's another problem to deal with.
Yeah. Oh, he's just running off. Don't even.
No, the mistake is all yours, scum.
Oh, God.
Now answer to the law.
I need to deal with you.
Well, when you put it like that... Okay, I'll look the other way. This time. Come to turn yourself in, huh?
No, I can't...
The mistake is all yours, scum. Now answer to the law. A small-time criminal? Not what I want on my service record.
Okay, I can't talk. I literally can't talk to him. Whatever, dude. I don't know, randomly he will talk to me and then he won't.
Name's Ayanala. Ayanala Darkhard. Best archer in Bruma. And perhaps all of Cyrodiil. What is it?
I don't think I talked to her. What do you do around here?
I offer archery training. For a price. To any who wish to learn and fight for coin and glory.
You sound bored.
Other than that, what more is there to do? Other than drink some fine ale at the tavern, of course.
You seem quite proud of your skill as an archer.
As I should be. Archery is something of a tradition in my family. My great-grandma Etla, they say she killed a man from over 300 yards. Talk about a good shot!
It does sound like a good shot. I can't help but notice that the surname Darkhart doesn't sound very friendly.
Only a shot a Darkhart could produce. One day, I'll beat that record.
What does it mean to be in the Fighters Guild?
Svenja and Aranir will talk your ear off about what the Fighters Guild does or doesn't mean to them. But for me, it's simple. To be in the Fighters Guild is to have a chance at true glory. One day, all of Tamriel will sing my name, and it will have all started here. The coin paid for each job doesn't hurt either.
Oh, of course not. What about helping the people of Cyrodiil?
That comes as part of the job. But that's what this is. A job. At the end of the day, if there wasn't a reward for contracts, then none of us would be here. Well, maybe apart from Svenja.
Do I see more? Yeah. Well, I can see both sides, but I guess that makes sense.
Of course it does. Houses don't come cheap, and either does food or mead.
I don't need training in archery, so...
Talk to you later.
Fare thee well.
Can I help you?
Nope, fare well. I'm looking for this guy's house. And here it is! Renod. No, get up on my account. I was gonna have a seat.
You are not fit to stand before me! Begone, Wastrel!
Well, that's why I'm sitting down. I have the loot, sir.
Wonderful! You have served your purpose, Rube. And for that, I am extremely surprised.
Grateful, I hope.
Go now, and know that you are tolerated by Renod Even-Toned.
What? Tolerated? What about your being a noise nuisance?
Ah yes, that insignificant matter. I will cut out the nighttime rehearsals and keep them for the morning. That is what you wanted, yes? Do not speak of this again, lest you lose my tolerance, Rube.
His face. His mouth stuck open. Inform Rontaine of your success. I guess that's a success? I didn't mean to do that. Trying to talk to him.
Oh, look! A pumpkin!
You're not escaping my grasp.
Oh, God.
Who's there?
Wait. No, Carlia. No! Crap, no! Jesus. Carlia!
What's going on here? Thought you could get away, huh?
It was him!
You are no match for a nightingale.
Alright, stand down. Stand down already. Yeah, this is not gonna go well. Well, how about that, huh?
You are not fit to stand before me! Begone, Wastrel!
What's with the hat?
The hat? The hat? You dare refer to it as a hat?
It is a hat.
This bumpkin? Is a Kalovian fur elm?
Yeah.
They were all the rage back in the third era.
We have to turn ourselves in.
Come to speak to the best bard in
all time. You follow me out.
Surprise. Go on, then.
Alright, turn me in. Turn me loose. No! I don't want to fight all of them.
Knew I heard something.
If I... I can't even... Wait, I'm supposed to be able to...
What was that?
Bound, once again.
I yield! I yield! I got the reload, guys. Not gonna be able to finish stuff without it. I yield. I yield.
Real pain. This is going to be.
Yeah. Auto save. These are all new saves. I'm gonna have to do that all over again. All the auto saves are from when this crap was going on. Well, guys, see you on the other side. I gotta do it all over again because I stole something by mistake. Okay, did it all again. The only thing I didn't do is try to talk to Adius Villius.
Oh, look! A pumpkin! Of course I am!
I mean to hit that.
Are you insulting my ability, pumpkin? Don't tempt me. Away with you, rube!
What's with the hat?
The hat? This pumpkin? But I... Soon, when you see all and sundry walking around sporting them, you'll know in the back of your...
He's gonna follow me out again. No? It's still pointing to him. Why is it still pointing to him? I'm supposed to track down Realm Tay. Till ran out about the job opportunity. I can't, I killed everyone. Alright, Realm Tay is down a few houses this way. Or he's behind the house. He's back here. Is he back here? All right. Where is he? That's... Oh, he's in here? Oh. He's in Icewind Traders? It's locked, though. Hold up. According to this, he's inside there, in Icewind Traders. And why is it locked so early? Well, he's behind it? I see him moving. Oh, there he is. Hey.
Please, madam. Just one step in.
I see nothing. I don't know why.
You're back. And that infernal screeching is gone. You convinced him?
He doesn't sing 24/7 either. This would be a lie because he'll still sing during the day. Happy to help.
Ah, this is a relief I've been yearning for months now. My most sincere thanks, honored friend.
Hope it's good enough.
While you were dealing with Renod, I went and asked around town.
You're loud all of a sudden.
People donated coin to a reward pot.
Oh, good.
People are much more willing to donate to this reward pot than they are to donate to a washed-up beggar, it seems.
Well, that's sad.
It is yours.
You know, it is true. I'm basically, like, close to being a millionaire in septums. I think you need it more than I. Keep it.
Truly, this moistens my scales.
No too much one information.
Has... This is not... What can I do with this gold, traveler? What could I do with it?
Buy some food? How much is it? It doesn't matter to me what you do with it.
I will go to Leowin and begin a new life. Perhaps even return to Blackmarsh in time.
What?
Thank you, honored friend. Thank you.
How much money did he get?
Here. Take this old keepsake of mine. I don't need it anymore.
What's that? Iron Mace of Sapping. Well, you weighed me down. Thanks a lot.
Friend?
What will you do with the gold?
I will put it into the fund that I've been putting together for a while now. To buy a house and get a roof over my head.
Okay.
It's growing slowly, but surely. Houses are... expensive.
Hmm. True. Very true. Notice this question was always here.
Farewell.
Mace of... I don't think I want this thing. It's heavy. Here. Come take that thing. I don't want it either. Alright, let's see if I can deal with Adius Vilius now. Just in case, I'm gonna save the game. Cause, jeez. God forbid anyone... I look at anyone funny. Or anyone... I wonder who sleeps here. Does Realm-Tay sleep here? Formally? Yeah, I look at anyone funny, these guys are gonna arrest me. Any of them look at me funny? Carlia is gonna start
my
swinging.
Hammer, a goblin's head, and a mug of ale.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a skeeving thug inside my house. When are you going to do something?
Don't judge me too harshly. I wasn't always the decrepit old horker you see before you. In my youth, I was quite something.
Huh? We're just ignoring him. Mind telling me some stories of your youth? Oh, there's what's your name?
Ah, you're back.
You bet I would. But, I'm sorry if this comes across the wrong way, traveler, but, well, I'm poor. I'm no good for jobs anymore, and people aren't going to pay you for just existing. So, tell you what, you give me a couple of septims, and I'll regale you with some stories. Sound like a fair trade, stranger?
Yeah. So you're a beggar then. Yeah, sure thing, and then I'll catch up with Adius Vilius and... He won't help me because I owe 5 septims or something.
Thanks, stranger. Rare to see such a generous sort here in Bruma.
Just wash those hands. Tell me a story.
It was a bright, sunny Turdus in Whiterun Hold.
Turdus.
I was hanging around Dragon's Reach, hoping to meet a rich noble lady and strike up a conversation.
Oh, yeah? Sugar Mama?
What can I say? I was young and naive. Imagine my surprise when out of the keep, instead of a noblewoman, comes a beautiful battle maiden, covered head to toe in beautifully crafted steel.
Even better.
She carried a huge steel claymore on her back, and I have no doubt that she'd have wielded it just as well, if not better, than any of the city guard.
Mm-hmm.
Paralyzed by panic, I remained silent, dared not to say anything to her. Even as she was breathing in my face.
Was she breathing in your face?
She chuckled, then asked me if I was up for a challenge. Said there were some bandits in a local cave, marked it on my map, and challenged me to clear it out. Blinded by my own lust, I accepted. She handed me that glistening greatsword she carried on her back. I wasn't trained with a weapon, but I was strong. I could hold it, unlike most.
So you were a follower?
She said she was impressed by that. So I took the greatsword to the cave she had described. Well, it was actually a mine of sorts.
Oh!
Ember Shard, they called it.
Ember Shard
I
Mine.
I hid inside.
It's by River Run, I think.
On the slope, I could just see, through the gloom, the red glowing eyes of a Dunmer. I assumed he was a bandit, but I wanted to be sure. Foolish and young, that was me. So, like a damned fool, I called out to him. What are you doing down here? I asked. He said nothing, but I saw his eyes narrow with anger in the dark. Then they got larger and larger, and I heard footsteps. He was coming towards me. I was done for. Then, all of a sudden, I heard a clink. The Dunmer had stepped on a pressure plate. And just like that, a whole pile of boulders came crashing down from the rafters and crushed him under them. That was one bandit dealt with. His screams as he died, and the sound of the rocks falling, attracted the attention of the rest of the bandits in the mine.
I'm sure it did.
I heard who I can only assume was their leader shout, in his typically guttural orcish voice. Seems like we've got company, boys. Weapons out. Eyes peeled. Let's go. I hid in the darkness, once again paralyzed by fear and doubt. Then an idea struck me. What if I made a trap of my own? I took the battle maiden's longsword and put it up in the rafters where the boulders were. I rearmed the pressure plate to the best of my abilities. Just as I was finished, the orc rounded the corner, as did a band of other brigands. One of them held a torch and waved it around to illuminate the whole entranceway.
He's listening.
Soon enough, they saw me. That was it. My big moment. My life or my death.
I'm guessing you lived.
The orc saw the boulders on the ground. I can only assume he took it as a sign that the trap had already been triggered and was safe to stand on. And so he stood on the plate. That was his big mistake. The great sword came careening down from the rafters with a force the likes of which I'd never seen before. By the blessings of Stendar, it impaled him straight through the gut. He bled what looked like lakes full of blood, and no sooner had I blinked than he died. The rest of the bandits very close behind him tripped over his flailing feet as he fell. They went diving headfirst into the rocks that lay on the ground, and the blow on the head ended them too. It was then that the door opened behind me. My heart damn near stopped. The bandits wanted their retribution, I thought. My life's reached its end. But it was the Battle Maiden. She had realized I might have taken her joke seriously, and so she came to try to warn me before it was too late.
Huh. She was kidding.
We saw them all there, lying dead, including the orc who had the greatsword still sticking out of him.
What happened to the
her
base?
Her eyes widened in
the
shock.
The base of your
Let's
voice.
Let's just say I was economical with the truth when explaining what happened during the encounter. It was then she told me she was one of the companions.
Oh, sweet.
An order of warriors based out of Whiterun.
Which one?
She said I had what it takes to be one of them. And
Ayala?
So I joined up the next day.
Ayala, I think her name is.
And that's the story of how a few happy accidents got me into a life of adventuring, I suppose. Funny the way the world works.
Hmm. Are there more stories?
Of course, for a small donation.
Let's see if he tells a different one.
Thanks, stranger. Rare to see such a generous sort here in Bruma.
We like stories. Tell me a story.
The companions had given me my first job, to slay a giant.
Cool.
Yes, to slay a giant. I had the same look on my face, too.
I was smiling.
They said they had no other jobs available at the time. When they gave me it, somehow I felt strangely kind of hopeful. I was on a high, you might say, from the events in Embershard. I was still afraid, but determined. That air of cockiness remained until I got near the giant's camp. Every step I took closer to the camp, the faster my heart raced. I couldn't do it, I finally thought to myself. Only 30 or so paces away from the camp, I had to turn back. But what would the companions think of me doing that? Dishonor! I couldn't ruin this for myself. This opportunity to become a hero of legend, I had to do something. And so, I cheated. In a way. I had asked a band of traveling mercenaries to do the deed for me. I paid them with what gold I had scrounged off the bandits I'd killed in Embershard. They reluctantly agreed, after a lot of persuasion, and so they charged in. I heard every stomp, every smash of the giant's club, echoing, bouncing off of the mountains. My heart pounded. Had I sent some men to their doom? If they are victorious, am I now an honorless coward? After about 5 minutes, they returned to me, beaten, battered, bruised, broken. They'd killed the giant and gotten its distinctively fungal toe the companions demanded as proof. It was then they held out on me. They told me they wouldn't give me the toe. Not after all that. Not after such risk for such little reward.
They already did it all.
It was fortuitous, I suppose, that the giant's mammoth came charging out of nowhere and, with its huge tusks, killed all three men. Just like that.
Pretty lucky guy.
I grabbed the toe from the ground where it landed and ran. I ran all the way back to Jorvesker. I explained what happened, and the companions were aghast at my cowardice. It was then that the Harbinger came out of his quarters. He signaled to them all, and just like that, they stopped talking out of respect.
Okay, I skipped a line. Is there more?
He opened his mouth. And I dreaded what he was about to say. But he didn't say what I expected him to. Not at all. He told them I deserved another chance. That this act of deception proved my ingenuity. He also told me that, by my description, these mercenaries were actually a small party of bandits that the companions had been hired to kill. He gave me the bounty for both them and the giant. To this day, I don't think I deserved it. But he insisted. And so I remained a companion yet longer, This is where I went on a series of adventures as a companion, completing jobs as I got them. Nothing too exciting. The next story worth telling takes place many, many years later.
Okay. I hope you guys enjoy this. I am enjoying the stories.
Of course, for a small donation. Thanks, stranger. Rare to see such a generous sort here in Bruma. I was a companion, but the pay wasn't so good. As I had learned, I wasn't a very good warrior, or a particularly brave one.
I managed to get by taking on jobs to clear skeevers out of people's homes. We have some lines skipping here.
So I ended up quitting, dropped my sword on the ground, and said enough was enough. They said farewell to me, and I decided I'd try my luck as far away from Yorvaskar as I could think to go. Bravel. See if there was much work available. Little did I realize that those stories about Breville's criminal underworld weren't just fabrications or exaggerations.
He said it two different ways.
They were as real as Masser or Secunda.
Bravel
or Breville?
I got blackmailed
into joining the criminal underworld of Breville. Helped the shady character who I never got the name of with some smuggling jobs. It wasn't nice or pleasant, but it paid better than my companion days. It was then that I saw coming into the city through the gate that battle maiden. She recognized me and was dismayed that I had been working for a man she'd come to clean out.
Oops.
Apparently, she was on a personal crusade against this kind of criminal filth. She was disappointed that I'd joined them.
Hmm.
I explained my reasons and my regret, and she saw fit to take pity on me. Thanks, Stendar, for that. We became close friends, and I eventually proposed to her on a beautiful summer's sunset.
And that's how she became my wife. Sadly, she passed a few years ago.
Oh.
Life's never been the same since.
Voice is messed up.
And that's the last of my interesting stories, I'm afraid. And certainly the most, soppy.
So his voice keeps losing its bass every now and then, and every once in a while he skips a story. So it's not Aella the Huntress, because she is not married. She's still back at Yorvaskar.
You've been kind and generous enough to listen to an old man's tales, so I'm happy to tell you some stories again for free.
Same one?
Thanks, stranger. Rare to see such a generous sort here in Bruma.
Give you anything. Yeah, we've heard these. Okay.
Leaving already? Oh, all right.
Oh, Adius is still sitting there.
Come to turn yourself in, huh?
God, no.
Don't think word doesn't get around. You're on the wrong side of the law. Well, when you put it like that... Okay, I'll look the other way. This time. Come to turn yourself in, huh?
If that's what I have to do, fine.
Don't think word doesn't get around. Your stolen goods have been confiscated, your fine is paid, everything seems to be in order. You're free to go, and I'll be watching you.
Yeah, I'll go get my stuff back. What's the situation here?
So now old Botram's got a thug inside his house, apparently. Just wonderful. To be honest, I'd rather be dealing with this than going on Count Carvain's wild guar chase. I should ask before I march in there and deal with the thief. Did your investigation turn up any leads about the Count's precious artifacts?
Yes, actually. The thief's going to deliver them to a contract in the Bruma Caverns.
You found a lead. That's no small relief. I guess that means you go find him in the caverns while I go deal with the thief in Bartram's house.
Apparently the trapdoor in Bartram's house leads to the caverns.
That changes things. Well, at least now we can kill two birds with one stone. If it's true, that is. Under most circumstances, I'd insist on going in first. I'm captain of the guard. It's my duty to shoulder the risk. But, well, this reeks of an ambush. It makes more sense to go in prepared.
Hmm.
Let's go.
Alright, guess he is going in first. Because I'm running back to the jail to get my stolen stuff back. Which he teleported in there. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time when we go in the house and check out Bruma Caverns. Until then, always seek adventure.